about the North Shore Technology Council is that it is a place where there have been a lot of stories, a lot of things that have taken place, a lot of connections that have been made, a lot of businesses that have been started, a lot of jobs that have been found. And we have a number of testimonials tonight from specific people that have had their lives impacted rather significantly by the Tech Council.
And as a result of all the networking and knowing the landscape, you know, I've been able to take a single proprietorship into an independent business. I just wanted to thank all of you because you made this happen.
Really, out of that, I made so many profound connections because of the North Shore Technology Council.
And one of the great things that Matt said was that people open their Rolodex for each other. All you have to do is ask.
So we ended up putting on a summit, and we had Congressman Tierney give the keynote speech at Analogic. Bernie Gordon, having started Analogic, I'm not sure that you gave the permission for that at that time, but we did there. We had about 80 people there, and we started the concept. We started the first Friday Bioscience after that, and at that summit in 2006, came the idea, boy, we need an incubator to get the life sciences cluster out here going.
The Tech Council, as a lot of people have noted tonight, is a group of individuals, and it just amazes me how well this collective group of people works together. It's a volunteer organization, but we accomplish an incredible amount, and I think as a result of what we see brought here tonight, with the number of people that have shown up in support of what we're trying to do, it's a reflection of what we've accomplished over the last 10 years.
The last year, I've given talks at MIT and Tufts and Worcester Tech and Northeastern to young students. And I say to them, I want you to look at me. I'm old. I think I'm older than anybody in the room here. And I said, I have a great advantage over you young people. I got brought up in a depression. But don't worry. You'll soon have that advantage. Around the greater Boston area, there's at least 100,000 highly educated technical people. At least. And there's not 100 of them that can run a complex engineering project successfully. I used to say that a couple of years ago, and presidents of colleges would say, you're nuts, but they agree now. We see no shortage of people with ideas, but there's a tremendous shortage of the common sense, the knowledge, the experience to bring an idea into a genuine product. And that's where I think the North Shore Council can do a tremendous job in improving.
The climate that the North Shore Technology Council has created for all of us to be able to look at those things, to understand the tremendous human capital that we have in our region, and to understand that when they are linked together, there is no limit to the potential for our part of the state and indeed for the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. Even more than recognizing this moment in time, to think about what the next 10 years will hold as we see the unfolding of that potential in a far greater way than it would otherwise be realized because of the ability of people in our part of the state to connect to each other, to share information, to inspire each other, and yes, in some ways, through the sense of competition, even to motivate each other. But at the end of the day, we'll all be better off because that infrastructure exists, that climate exists, and the leadership that this council has created will continue to propel us into the next decade of its existence. So Jim, I'd like to present you with this citation on behalf of, again, myself and my colleagues in the Senate to say congratulations and best wishes for a very bright future.